Hello everyone, Luis here. In today's video, I will show you the entire process of 3D printing a very beloved character from the Mandalorian series, the child, or best known as Baby Yoda, right? I will show you the end-to-end process on how to do that using a resin 3D printer. This is a video more oriented for beginners, people thinking about starting resin printing, or even as a curiosity video for people in general and would like to see the entire process and how we turn liquid resin inside this bottle into beautiful models like this little guy here. And stay with me, and since this is a Baby Yoda video, my son, who is a baby himself, has something to say to you, okay?
Thanks for watching, subscribe and like.
So, thank you, and let's get started. First step is to find the file. There are some good sources up there to find files for print, both free and paid. I will link some sources of models in the description. The most well-known place is Thingiverse, and this particular model is easily found there. So Thingiverse is where I'll get this model. So just find the file and download it to your computer. Second step is to check the file integrity and hollow the file. Especially people who are starting the hobby now do not have this notion that you can hollow a model for two reasons. First one is more obvious: if a model is hollowed, it will spend less resin. The other reason is to reduce the surface of contact with the fab and reduce the peeling force that can lead to fails. You can hollow it in your slicer program of preference, or you can use Windows 3D Builder for that. Today, just to teach you a new trick, I'm going to use 3D Builder, but again, you can use Chitubox, Lychee, Photon Workshop to hollow your model. And the good thing about 3D Builder is that you have two tools in one. You can check the integrity, and also you can hollow the model only in one place, okay? To know more about how to repair 3D models, I've created a special video about this subject, so please, if you are interested in this subject, take a look. I will leave the link here for you guys to check, okay? Now we have our model hollowed, and it's time to open it on the slicer. Support the model and slice it. I'm not a professional support specialist. I'm doing supports more like any regular hobbyist will do. Place support is something you get better over time, and there are other specialists on YouTube that know that much better than me, like Greg from 3D Printing Pro. I will leave a link here for his channel for you guys to check, okay? Again, a support placement will work, but it's far from perfect, and it's a good start for any beginner. I'm more on the school of over-supporting, as you can see. I prefer to have more supports and avoid fails than have less and need to clean my bed and waste resin, okay? I just use the alt support, then I place some medium supports. I start with light on the alt support, then I place mediums on critical areas of the model, like the initial layers, and also I like to reinforce more critical areas like the ears, for example, here, which is a more flat area. So this area needs more supports to make sure that it will not have a pancake of ear on your build plate, okay? This is how I do on Lychee. Lychee also has an interesting feature of island detector. So as you can see, I'm searching for island, and I'm placing supports on those islands automatically. I will show also the process on Chitubox next, okay? So on Chitubox is basically the same thing. I use the same method. The commands are different, but yeah, you need to get familiar with it. But both slicers work the same way. You put all your out supports, and in my case I put all lights, then I reinforce with some mediums, and also I reinforce critical areas like the ears with more supports, like three like supports, and again I'm all over supports instead of just have a fail on a build plate. Okay, feel free to use the same technique, but I really recommend you to check other content creators with more experience than me on creating supports. Okay. The next step now is to check your settings to see if the configuration of the resin that you are going to use is okay. In this case, I'm going to print on my Bene 4 and I'm checking if everything's okay. And here the slicer is really slicing the file into different layers, and that's how your printer will print your file. It will cure layer by layer until you have entire model on your build plate. Okay, at the end it shows how much resin you're going to use and the time. Chitubox is the same thing. Check your resin. In this case, I'm going to use my photo mono, and you slice your file here and just check layer by layer here. Okay, save the file, and then you are going to get your USB from the printer. Stick your USB on your PC and save the file there, and then get your USB back to the printer. Okay, in case of the Bene 4 mono, I've sent it through Wi-Fi. Okay, now I'm on the printer and I will just prepare the printer to start to print, right? I'm shaking the resin. It's important to shake your resin always, okay? This is a chemical compound. The element separates, so it's important for you to shake everything to have a uniform resin and do not have problems to print, okay? Here the print process starts, so it's basically prepare your printer to start print. You check if everything is in place, you have the resin already in your resin tank, and you start to print, basically that. The build plate will go up, down, and up and down many times during the printing process. Each time it goes down, it will cure one layer of the model, okay? And it will repeat that many times over during the process. Thank you. After you finish to print, you notice that the model is all wet with like uncured resin. And the next process is basically clean the model. I'm using a washing cure station here, the Elegoo Mercury Plus, but you can use like a pickle jar or a jar or any container that you can use IPA and wash your print, okay? But definitely use a washing cure. It's really a fast way to do that and super simple. Just define the time, the machine just clean the print and that's it. I like to use a soft toothbrush to help clean the model. As you can see here, even using the out supports, even using the default settings from the slicer, I can have very easy supports to remove. I remove almost everything by hand. So yeah, that's it. You clean and remove the supports there. And sometimes you need help from a tool to do that, from the cutter. So you can use it, or you can use the cutter always. It avoids damage sometimes to the model, okay? So that's it for today's video. It's not something super complicated to print those little guys. Hope it was fun and helpful for you guys, as it was good for me to make this content. I made it special for you, so enjoy it. And if you did not subscribe yet, please consider subscribe to be notified for future content like this, okay? Thank you and see you next time. Bye.